here and I'm getting ready to go out the door to go to the store because I've got to find a new pair of shoes. I have a special party I have to go to and I'm on my way, so I'll catch up with you at the store. See you later. I'm inside and I'm shoe shopping. Let's see what I can find. I hope there's something really cool that I can wear. Oh my gosh, do you see what I see? It's the elf on the shelf. Is he following me? I don't know. Well, I'm gonna turn around and look for shoes and see if he stays with me. See you later. Well, I'm back from shopping. I did find a nice pair of shoes, and that elf was everywhere with me. And there he is again. I guess he's reporting to Santa as to whether I've been naughty or nice. So I thought maybe I would read a story about elves today. And I have one about the elf that keeps following me. I also have one about the elves and the shoemaker because they're making shoes and I looked for a pair of shoes today. I also have one that's Once Upon a North Pole Christmas. I don't know if we'll have time to read that one, but that's another story about elves. And I have a silly one. A mustache baby. It's about an elf who has a mustache. Well, let's start with this one. So maybe we can understand why these elves keep following us. Have you seen an elf in your house? Do you have an elf on your shelf? Maybe you do. And I guess he might report to Santa. I don't know why else he would be here. This is called Meet the Scout Elves. It says, "Welcome to the North Pole." The North Pole is a magical place where Santa and his elves live. But these are no ordinary elves. It says, "Welcome, Santa, North Pole, mailroom workshop." Yes, they're busy little elves. These are scout elves. Scout elves have many different skills. They are great candy painters and speedy mailroom sorters. Scout elves are terrific toy testers too. But their biggest job is being reporting scout elves. So they report. Reporting scout elves are very important. They are Santa's most trusted helpers. Each scout elf is assigned to a family. Every year, scout elves fly across the world. They can't wait to see you. I don't know, is it a secret? I think he's just winking at us. Reporting scout elves love to share fun and good cheer. They wear pointy hats and red suits with white collars. Some elves wear funny costumes, too. I think they are cute. That one looks like he's trying to be a snowman. Each day, scout elves find a spot in their family's home. Ah, they love to play hide and seek. I can see that. Your elf could be anywhere. It could be on a shelf, excuse me, or even in your stocking. Each night, scout elves fly back to the North Pole. They tell Santa all the nice things you've done. This helps Santa make his nice list. When elves are on the job, they become very still. Scout elves can only move when you are not looking. They are good listeners, but can't talk to you. This is what makes them such good helpers for Santa. That is an elf on a shelf. Scout elves have many other talents as well. A good scout elf can hide and sneak behind presents. No two scout elves are the same. They each have different names and personalities. What's your elf's name? Why, I didn't name mine. Do you have a name for yours? I guess I better think of one. Is it Snowflake or Sprinkles? Maybe it's Blink. It could even be Popsicle. These elves waste no time making themselves at home. You may notice that in the morning, your elf has not moved. Do not panic. Scout elves will sometimes return to their favorite spot in the house. Make sure to check on them later in the day. Be sure to treat your elf kindly. If scout elves are accidentally touched, they might lose their magic. Not to worry. There are three ways you can restore a scout's elf's magic. First, write a note to say, sorry. Second, sprinkle a little cinnamon near your elf. Cinnamon is like a vitamin for elves. It will help them regain their magic. Third, elves love Christmas carols. Try singing one with your family. Maybe you could sing, jingle bells, jingle all the way, or whatever one you can think of. Then comes the big day. It's Christmas morning. Santa left you presents. Your elf must have done a great job telling Santa how good you were. Every reporting scout elf loves Christmas Day. They return to the North Pole for a big celebration. Elves will celebrate a job well done by playing in the powdery snow. Oh, what fun! That does look like fun. See you next year! Merry Christmas! So now at least I understand why the little elf is following me around. I guess he's going to report back to Santa, and maybe he likes shoe shopping too. But since we talked about the shoes, this story is about elves and the shoemaker. And if you look at them, they're dressed kind of funny. Not like you and I. So this happened a long time ago. So let's find out about these elves. It says, once upon a time, there was a very poor shoemaker. Though he worked hard, he kept getting poorer. At last, he and his wife had no money and no food left. All the shoemaker had was enough leather to make one pair of shoes. What will they do? That's so sad. The shoemaker cut out the leather. Then he sighed. I'm too tired to do any more work tonight, he said. I'll finish the shoes in the morning. He left the leather on his workbench and he went upstairs to bed. When he went to his workbench the next morning, the shoemaker couldn't believe his eyes. Instead of the leather, he found a pair of beautiful shoes already made. Did you make these shoes? He asked his wife. No, she replied. But put them in the window. Perhaps we can sell them. Soon, a well-dressed man came into the shop.
May I try on the shoes in the window? He asked.
The shoemaker brought him the shoes.
These are perfect, said the man. They are the finest shoes I have ever seen. You deserve a good price for such excellent work. And he gave the shoemaker 5 pieces of silver.
Wow, back then that was a lot of money. With the money, the shoemaker was able to buy food and more leather. Now he had enough for 2 pair of shoes. As before, he cut out the leather and left it on his workbench so that he could finish making the shoes in the morning. The next day, there were 2 pairs of fine shoes waiting for him. Somebody's making the shoes. I bet I know who it is. The shoemaker put the shoes in the window, and after a while, some customers came to try them on. The customers liked the shoes and paid the shoemaker well for them. Now, the shoemaker had enough money to buy leather for 4 pair of shoes. He cut out the leather and left it on his workbench, and in the morning, he found 4 pairs of brand new shoes. Wow, that's great. The same thing happened again and again. Every night, the shoemaker cut out some leather and left it on his workbench. Every morning, he found handsome new shoes waiting for him. Before long, he and his wife were rich. One winter evening, the shoemaker's wife said, "We have been very lucky. A few months ago, we had nothing. Now we have everything we could wish for. We must find out who has been helping us so we can thank them."
"Yes," said the shoemaker, "if we stay up and watch tonight, perhaps we can see who has been making the shoes."
That sounds like a good idea. That night, the shoemaker and his wife hid in the corner of the shop and they waited. Do you see them? Right there they are. And I see the elves. At midnight, the door opened. And 2 tiny elves came running in. Oh, they went straight to the workbench and began sewing the leather and the shoemaker that the shoemaker had left there. The shoemaker and his wife, they stared in amazement. I would have too. The elves worked without stopping until all the shoes were finished. Then just before dawn, they left.
Those elves have made us rich, said the shoemaker to his wife. We must find a way to repay them. Did you see how thin and tattered their clothes were? Said his wife. And their little feet were bare. It's cold outside, and there's snow on the ground. Why don't we make some clothes and boots to keep the elves warm? Well, that sounds like a lovely idea. Let's see if they were able to do that. All the next day, the shoemaker and his wife were busy making tiny shirts, trousers, coats, hats, and boots for the elves. That night, they set everything out on the workbench. Then they hid and waited for the elves to arrive. At the stroke of midnight, bing, the door opened and the elves dashed in, ready for work. At first, they were confused to find clothes instead of leather on the bench. Then they realized that the clothes were for them, just their size. The elves put on the clothes. When they saw their reflections in the shop window, they were so delighted that they sang a little song. Oh, what handsome boys are we. We are. We will work on shoes no more. Oh, they're not going to work anymore. Oh, what handsome boys we are. We will work on shoes no more. They danced happily around the room, leaping onto chairs and over benches. They skipped out of the door. The elves didn't come back, but the shoemaker and his wife never forgot them. Their good fortune continued, and they lived happily for the rest of their lives. Well, you can see on this page that the shoes look a little different than what we wear today. And I happen to have some little shoes to show you what they may have looked like a long time ago. The first pair I have, and I can hang them on my Christmas tree. I love shoes just like the elves. And this is pretty fancy. So that might have been some of the shoes that they made in their shop as well. And let's take a look at another one. Oh, this one looks like it could be one that Mrs. Claus would wear. That's a fancy boot with fur around it. Pretty snazzy. And here's a gold one. They wore a lot of boots a long time ago, and we still wear boots today. They just look a little different. And maybe a shoe like that might have been from a long time ago as well. Well, I happen to have some shoes that could have been in the shoemaker's window. Let's take a look. Oh, these are the shoes on the shelf. Not the elf on the shelf this time, but the shoes on the shelf. And my little elf is still watching. I guess he's checking things out. Take a look. These might have all been shoes that they had. They don't look so much like the ones we wear as like something like this. That's pretty fancy. And that is what the ladies would have worn a long time ago. But I happened to put price tags on them. So I'm going to point to a shoe and I'd like you to hold up your fingers to tell me how many that is. Now, these are all dollars, and dollars look like this. This is a pretend dollar. And a long time ago, the shoes weren't very expensive because things didn't cost as much as they do today. So let's see if we can get started with this. Okay, I'm going to start with all the ones that are pointing in that direction. They're pointing, their toes are pointing to the right. So let's see, this one has the number
5. Can you see that? So can you hold up 5 fingers for me? That's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one cost $5. I couldn't buy a pair of shoes for $5 today. Next, that is another kind of boot, and it says the number 4. How many is 4? Can you show me 4 fingers? 1, 2, 3, 4. And over here, well, I'm gonna do this side first. We have one that says 2. Can you show me 2 fingers? 1, 2. Good for you. Ah, this one is snazzy. It's gold and it's tall. And what's that number? If you said 6, you are right. For 6, I'm going to need 2 hands. So how many fingers would that be? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's go to the next side. Ooh, that's a fancy one with a real pointy toe. Those shoes are looking towards the left. And that one says 3. Can you show me 3 fingers? 1, 2, 3. Let's go to this one. What's that number? That one says 2. How many is 2? 1, 2. Let's go to the next one. That's a taller boot. Not as tall as this one, but let's see what that number is. If you said 6, you are right. Can you show me 6 fingers again? We need 2 hands for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this fancy pair, what's that number? That number says 4. How many are 4 fingers? 1, 2, 3, 4. All of these are $4. We don't have dollars to show, but we have fingers we can use. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Someone must have bought the spare shoes because it's empty. Let's see what we have here. Ah, I see someone moved it. Just like in the store, sometimes they move things around. This one says 3. Can you show me 3 fingers? 1, 2, 3. And over here, what is that number? If you said 1, you are right. That is $1. So how many shoes did we have all together on the shelf today? Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 shoes. I bet you could show me 10 fingers. Let's count them one more time. Make sure I didn't miss any. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 shoes on the shelf in the shoemaker's shop. Can you show me 10 fingers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And there we go. We have some shoes that are the same colors, like this one, and this one, and this. These are all brown. And then we have one black one. And these are all different, but these
both have green in them. So those have green and these have brown. The others are different colors. So you can group them that way too. Or we could find all the boots and put the boots together. These are all the boots. And we could put all the heels, the high heels together. So that would be these. They have higher heels than the other ones. And these have lower heels. So you can group them in different ways. That's kind of fun to do. I have a poem yet before we go. And it goes like this. Actually, it's a song. So I'm gonna see if you might be able to help me. It's about the elves and their shoes. When there's a part that goes tap, 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 you can tap, tap, tap with your fingers. And it goes like this. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. They are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. They are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. They are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. One more time. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. They are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. Someone's making brand new shoes. Yes, they are. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. Making tap, they are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. We will hide tonight and see them. Yes, we will. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. They are tapping all night long, making shoes new and strong. It's the elves who are working. Yes, it is. And that's our song for today and our stories for today. And maybe you have an elf on your shelf or one who's following you around. Maybe you gave him a name. I think it's fun. He's pretty cute. I don't mind if he stays. Until next time, see ya. Bye.